Haptic cinema can affect us in many different ways, particularly our emotions, such as happiness, love, sadness, anger, and fear.
Another emotion that audiences can feel during films is happiness. This emotion can be shown in film through many ways, such as characters smiling, body language, as well as happy moments occurring in the narrative. Some examples could be a wedding, passing a difficult test, or accomplishing a lifelong goal. This experience through film is explored in the Myra Smith reading, Engaging Characters. Observing the behavior of a person in a certain situation about which we have limited knowledge, we imaginarily project ourselves into their situation
and
hypothesize as to the emotions they are experiencing.
Happiness also has a lot of sub-emotions. This includes excitement, joy, humor slash laughter, and satisfaction. Excitement is demonstrated in the 1996 film Independence Day.
We're going to live on. We're going to survive. Today, we celebrate our Independence Day.
Joy is demonstrated in the 2014 film Whiplash. Humor is shown in the 1990 TV series, Mr. Bean. Finally, satisfaction is demonstrated in the 1990 film, Home Alone.
We as viewers get emotional while watching romance films or sad films that have love aspects involved, which is totally normal. Humans are emotional beings. It's not surprising that we laugh along with characters in these films when they laugh, or when they cry, we cry too. We relate to these characters the most out of any genre because they are just like us, with problems just like us. We have all been totally infatuated with someone or something at some point. Lust is very real also, especially at a young age. Jealousy will forever be constant throughout our lives. Nothing can stop that. Betrayal is something that isn't very common, but it's something we've all experienced at some point in our lives, which is why we can feel for the characters in a film when it happens to them.
There are many sub-emotions relating to love, one of them being infatuation. Infatuation can be seen in the movie Lord of War.
Time to say, I love you, 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 I do. This is why I love you. This is why I love you.
There is then jealousy. Jealousy can be seen in the old Shakespearean play Othello.
Are you sure of that?
I have not deserved this.
Third up is lust. Lust can be seen in the 1999 film Cruel Intentions, which stars Reese Witherspoon and Ryan Phillippe, who are lovers.
Trevor. It's funny how you haven't mentioned him until now.
He's backpacking through Europe.
And finally is betrayal. Betrayal can be seen in the film The Room, starring Tommy Wiseau, who has just been cheated on by his wife.
Part of my life, you are everything. I could not go on without you, Lisa.
You're scaring me.
You are lying. I never hit you. You are tearing me apart, Lisa.
Why are you so hysterical?
Movies try to relate to the audience when it comes to sad and emotional events and characters. Most people have experienced some sort of sadness in their life, no matter how big or small they are. Be it betrayal, depression, mourning, despair, or heartbreak. Betrayal can be seen in the 1974 movie The Godfather Part 2, when Michael discovers that his brother has conspired against him with the enemy.
I know it was you, Fredo. You broke my heart.
Depression can be seen in the 2014 movie American Sniper, when Bradley Cooper's character is shown going through the stages of PTSD. Grief can be seen in the 2008 movie Marley and Me, when Owen Wilson's character is shown accompanying his dog's final moments on Earth.
Remember how we were always saying what a pain you are? You're the world's worst dog. Don't believe it. Don't believe it even for a minute. As you know, we couldn't find...
The Spare is shown in the 2012 movie Life of Pi, when Pi realizes that he's all alone, stranded in the middle of nowhere.
My name is Pi Patel. I have been in a shipwreck. I am on a lifeboat alone with the tiger. Please send help.
Anger is another emotion that an audience can feel towards a film. Not necessarily because the movie is particularly bad, but because of the characters, actions, or events transpiring on screen. In the 2012 film Prometheus, the characters can be seen running away from a crashing ship. However, this is really frustrating for the audience, as the characters can easily walk to the side to avoid being killed by the ship. In the television series Game of Thrones, Joffrey is a character that the audience can find very easy to hate, especially since that he has very few redeeming qualities and is exceptionally evil towards other characters in the series.
Killing you would send your brother a message.
But my mother insists on keeping you alive.
Annoyance can be seen in the television series The Big Bang Theory. Not only do the characters in the series find him annoying, but the audience does as well.
Penny!
What?
Jealousy can be seen in the 2013 movie Her, when the main character discovers that his artificial intelligence girlfriend has cheated on him with hundreds of other people.
How many others?
Horror in film, and the film Repulsion in particular, insidiously invite us to get close and to take pleasure in the placidity of its images, that being calm or quiet and sometimes beautiful, only to horrify us when these images begin to slither, creep, and erupt with things we'd rather keep at a distance. Whether this form of cinema can be perceived as haptic cinema, which is something that relates to us, something we can touch, may be an effect of the work itself, or it may be a function of the viewer's disposition. We fear being stalked, and we all have phobias, some greater than others. Fear also has a number of its own sub-emotions. First up is horror. In William Friedkin's 1973 film The Exorcist, the horror in the form of religiophobia, which is a fear of religion or the unknown, is perfectly presented.
Holy cross of our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with the Father and the Holy Spirit.
Next is the emotion of disgust. A good example of disgust can be seen in the Evil Dead remake, which came out in 2013. Up is disturbance. This is in relation to the films that attack us psychologically. The Voices is about a man with severe mental illness who cannot tell apart what is real and what is fake in his life. This is something real that could possibly affect you at some point in your life, which makes it very scary. And finally is anxiety. A film that illustrates anxiety well is It Follows.